channel. So today we will discuss the new topic of Python programming. As we all know that this language is very latest language in these days, and many organizations and schools are working and developing projects and doing programming on this Python language. So we can say that this is a latest language in these days, and today we will discuss the various features and applications of Python. Before starting with this, I want to tell you that I have given number of lectures on my YouTube channel. I want you, each and everybody, should subscribe my channel so that I came to know that you are watching my lectures. So with the starting of this lecture, we came to the features of Python. So first feature is the high level language. As we are developing our projects and we are doing the programming and developing number of web pages, business applications and games while using Python programming, while using coding on Python. So we can say that this is a high level language. So the second point is that it is very simple language. How is it simple? Simple means we are using the simple English language, and the codes which we are using during the programming in Python, it is very simple and it is easy to understand. So we can say that Python is very simple language as comparative to C language. So the third point is the GUI. GUI means graphical user interface. As we are developing the web pages, we are maintaining our web games, 3D effects. So we can say that graphical user interface is very good feature of Python programming, and which we all are using the number of gadgets, number of web pages, number of business applications in AI also by using GUI, graphical user interface. So the next feature is a case sensitive. Case sensitive means when we are doing programming on Python, so we are using a small alphabet of A and capital alphabet of A. So there is a difference between a small a and a capital A in Python programming. So we can say that this language is a case sensitive language. Then it comes a second, next point is the platform independent. Platform independence means we can install a Python on any of the Windows operating system, Linux operating system. So because of installing a Python language in any of the operating system, we can say that it is a platform independence language. So the next one is a no compilation and linking is required. As in C programming, when we have to define any variable, we have to declare that variable first. But in Python, there is no need of the compilation and linking. We can direct link the variable to the operator. So we can say that no compilation and linking is required in the Python. Then we can say that in the next feature, it is an object-oriented programming. Object-oriented programming means we are using the OOPS concept in Python programming, and there is no structural programming in Python programming. So we can say that it is a object-oriented programming because we are using a number of OOPS concept in Python also. The next one is a few lines of code. While developing a program or a project on Python, we can do our programming in few lines of code. As in C programming, we have to develop a number of lines of codes, but in Python, we have to mention a few lines of codes while using the programming in Python. So the next feature is the no type declaration is required. Type declaration means if we are assigning any value, for example, if we are assigning A is equal to 5, then it means A is, the value of A is directly, it becomes a A is equal to 5. But in C, we have to define in A and A is equal to 5. So in C programming, we have to define that variable of A, then we have to assign the value of the particular variable. But in no type declaration is required in Python programming, we can directly execute the value of A is equal to 5 in Python. Then it comes the applications of Python. After doing the features of Python, we came to the applications of Python. As we all know, we are developing a number of web pages on Python, number of web developments. We are developing number of products, number of projects, number of web pages on Python. So we can, this application is very good application of Python, web developments. So then it comes a GUI. We are developing a number of front end on GUI, graphical user interface, so that it is very easy to occupy the number of front pages on the graphical user interface while using Python. So we are also using the third point is the business applications by the user. We are also using the Python language in developing a business application. Like we are using a tally, we are using number of software which are being maintained by using the Python programming in business applications. For example, of stock market and many other business applications are being developed by using this Python programming. So the next one is a game and 3Ds. So we can develop a number of games by using the Python programming. The number of games are being played on the mobile phone and the laptops also. These are the online games and they are using the 3D effects also. So we can say that this is a good application of Python programming. The next point is the assessing the database. Assessing the database as compared to C, in Python programming, we can assess the large amount of data and we can store the database as well while using the Python programming. So we can say that assessing the database is a good application of Python programming. Then at the last, I will tell you the how to install the Python programming in your laptop. So first of all, we will open the web browser of our laptop. From there, we will go to the Google and from there, we will type a python.org. When we click on to the enter, a web page of python.org will be opened and at there is a number of versions of web, python.org. There is a number of versions of Python. Then from there, the latest version is 3.8.0. We will select the latest version. Then we will click on to the download. It will take 3 to 6 minutes to download a Python language. Then we will click on to the run. And after run, we will click on to the install. The Python will be automatically installed to your laptop or a computer. So with this, I will finish my today's lecture. I hope you all understand it in a very good way. And I want all of you will please subscribe my channel. Thanks for today. Be safe and stay home.